This elegant courtyard was built in memory of Lu Zhi, a prime minister in Tang Dynasty. The inscription on this board says, "Loyalty and integrity for generations," dedicated to Lu, who was seen as an upright, clean, and diligent official who always cared for the people. September 2015, during a group study session of the Political Bureau of the CPC Central Committee, General Secretary Xi Jinping shared the story of Lu Zhi. She said, "Lu had been strict with himself and refused any tiny bit of bribes or presents." She said even the emperor himself suggested Lu could accept some small gifts such as boots and riding crops, which wouldn't damage his reputation. But Lu said that once he started accepting gifts, his appetite would grow, which might lead to corruption.
陆子在围相期间呢，就是跟下属和同僚在交往的时候呢，都是拒绝了他们的馈赠。唐德宗专门给陆子呢带话，告诉他呢，就是清廉太过，恐怕呢这个事情就办不成了。陆子呢，他多次向唐德宗上各种奏章。 他从心里希望唐德宗成为一个贤明的君主，所以呢，他这个有一次，唐德宗想搞小金库，想恢复这个琼林和大营两个金库。In
the year 783, Emperor Dezong sent troops to quell a rebellion. However, as they didn't have enough food to eat, some soldiers, dissatisfied with the imperial government, staged a coup and overtook the capital Chang'an. Emperor Dezong had to flee to a place called Fengtian. There, Lu Zhi advised the emperor to abandon the secret coffers, quoting an ancient philosopher's words that a monarch should follow protocol and remain upright and clean.
Lu Zhi used the Chonglin Daiying 自古修其制来否定了二库的存在的合法性，同时也指出了君王的事业膨胀，对于国家的极大危害。后来在陆子的劝解下，唐德宗下令撤去琼林大营匾额。For
his entire life, Lu had always remained a clean and upright official.
他早年就是说为官以后，然后有一年他回家乡探望母亲，那么路过寿州。 那么他去拜望这个寿州刺史张毅，张毅呢就私下给了他很多钱财，但是陆子他就是坚持不纳，就婉拒了。Many
years later, Lu's mother died of illness. When he returned to his hometown to pay tribute, many local officials and rich businessmen visited him and tried to offer large sums of money as condolences, but Lu rejected them all.
在封建官场。
贪腐成风的大环境之下，陆子他能够坚持秘而不知，为百姓做实事，成为清廉官吏的代表。当官就不要发财，发财就不要当官，清清爽爽的，义无反顾的去当官。习近平总书记讲述的陆子的故事，也是勉励我们广大党员干部严于律己、以干净。 担当的崇高品质，推动党和人民事业不断从胜利走向新的胜利。